In this lecture, we will clarify the steps to create a great altered sales dashboard. The complete dashboard will look like the following. First, we will create some metrics. Then, the second step is to create a table with the top three customers. Then, we will create a trend line chart showing the orders per quarter and per year. After that, we will create a donut chart showing the orders per region. The fifth step is to create a column chart showing the items with the most units. Finally, we will create slicers, helping us to filter our data. Let's start creating a dashboard. In this table, we have some fields like order date, customer, and total amount of orders. We will start by creating a pivot table. Go to Insert tab, Tables, and click Pivot Table. A new window appears. Make sure that the range is correct and includes all the data. Also, we want the pivot table to be placed in a new worksheet. Click OK. Now change the name of the worksheet. Double click and rename it to Dashboard. Before jumping into the design stage of your dashboard project, you need to ask the question, what problem am I trying to solve? So it's important to think what metrics or key performance indicators, KPIs, you need to track. The first metric I need is a sum of totals. Drag total field and drop it down to values area. And we are ready. To make it easier to read, right-click before cell and choose number format. Go to number category, 0 decimal places, and click the box Use a 1000 separator. Now follow the same steps to add units field into the values area. Let's do it. If you want to change the view of the sums, simply transfer values from columns to rows area. Like this. Okay, let's move it back. Change also the name of cell B2 to metrics. These metrics are the sum of totals and units. You can play with other types of calculation like count, average, max or min by right-clicking and choosing summarize values by. The next step is to create a table with the top three customers. Go back to Data Worksheet and we want a new pivot table that it will be placed in the existing dashboard worksheet. Click Insert, Tables, Pivot Table. Check again that whole range has included. Because the pivot table has to be placed onto an existing worksheet, we check this. Click Dashboard, A9 cell, and OK. Now drag Customers field and drop down to Rows area. Also drag and drop Total field in Values area. We need only the three customers with the largest orders, so we click this filter box, value filters, and then top 10. Change this number to 3 and click OK. The last step is to sort the table from largest to smallest. Right click, sort option, and then sort largest to smallest. The next step for our dashboard is to create a line chart. The line chart will give us a visual illustration of the orders, yearly and quarterly. But first we have to create a separate table with the fields we want. So we click on any cell in Data Worksheet, go to Insert tab and choose Pivot Table. We make sure that the range is correct and we choose the new pivot table to be placed in a new worksheet. Click OK. We rename the new worksheet to Year Quarter. Drag the field order date and drop it in the rows area. Same with total. Drag it and drop it into values area. The next step is to group our table by year and quarter. Right click and choose group. There are many options as you see. We are interested in quarters and years option. Click OK. Now we have our source data ready to use them. For the creation of the line chart, go to Analyze tab and click Pivot Chart. Choose the line chart I want to free up a little space and leave only the important elements of my chart. So delete this legend. And now we want to hide these buttons. From Analyze tab, click Field Buttons and choose Hide All. Finally, we will hide grid lines. We can use the plus icon tool. Go to grid lines and uncheck the box. When we create a dashboard, we want charts to be as simple as we can. The final step is to move the line chart. Go to Design tab and press Move Chart button. Move it to Dashboard Worksheet. And place it somewhere here. And we are finished with the graph. What we are going to do now is to create a donut graph, showing the percentage of totals for each region. The procedure is very similar with the previous we followed to create a line chart. So we click on any cell in Data Worksheet, go to Insert tab, and choose Pivot Table. We make sure that the range is correct and we choose the new pivot table to be placed in a new worksheet. Click OK. We rename the new worksheet to percentage per region. We drag the field region and drop it in rows area. The same with total. Drag the field total and drop it into values area. Now go to Analyze tab and click Pivot Chart. Choose the donut chart. Okay, ready. Delete the less important elements like title, legend, and also hide the field buttons. We would like a chart style with percentage labels and nice colors. So go to Design tab and check the different chart styles. I prefer Style 8. You can choose whatever you want. From the same tab, go to Quick Layout and click Layout 1. We finish with appearance of the chart and now we are ready to move it. Click there and move it to Dashboard. Ready. It's useful for a dashboard to have a graph showing the items with the largest units. We decided to create a 3D cluster chart. To do that, we must create a new pivot table with two fields, item and units. Let's start. From Data Worksheet, go to Insert tab and choose Pivot Table. We take a glance at the cells of the range, checking if they are correct, and we choose the new pivot table to be placed in a new worksheet. Click OK. We rename the new worksheet Units per Item. Drag the field item and drop it in rows area. Also drag the field units and drop it in values area. Now go to Analyze tab and click Pivot Chart. Choose the 3D cluster chart. Okay, ready. Delete the title, legend, and hide the fields button. From Design tab, click Move Chart and place it to the dashboard. The best way to filter our data fast and easy is by using slicers. Slicers look like buttons that can filter specific data like region, year, or a customer. We can insert slicers from Analyze tab. The tab appears if we click in any cell from Pivot Table. Okay, now click Insert Slicers. We are going to use region, customers, and years. Click OK. It's important to resize slicers and fit to the area of the dashboard. From Options tab, we would first like to increase the columns. Like this, and then to resize slicers and align them. If you want, you can change the slicer style. next step is to generate the report connections. This option allows us to link slicers with different pivot tables. Click on the year slicer, press Report Connections button, and check all the pivot table boxes. We are going to do the same with other slicers. A fantastic feature in Excel 2013 is timelines. Click any cell in the pivot table and go to Analyze tab. You see an option called Insert Timeline. Click on it. First, make sure that all report connections are enabled. Time slicer is ready, and we can change the filter if we want years or quarters from there. Now it's time to modify our dashboard visually. Go to View tab and uncheck these three options: Grid Lines, Formula tab, and Headings. We managed to create a beautiful dashboard. Thank you very much. Yeah.